What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Team Solemn Circus live video. To the left side here, we have Purrely going up against Labrynth here. You know, the Purrely deck on the recent ban list got hit up to 2 Delicious, being a nice little boost from their deck. And they also got a nice little reprint in the Rarity Collection too, you know, dropping, I believe, last weekend. Pretty nice. I guess a drop yesterday at OTS or at non-OTS stores. You know, pretty nice being able to pick up your Purrely cards. I want to feature the channel a little bit more, because of the fact that I thought maybe people want to be seeing it. We see a copy of, like, I think it's Pretty Happiness, and of course Purrely being reprinted, you know, being a little bit of the ultra rares being a little bit more expensive than the other ones. We're going to be seeing the effect of my friend going to be revealing the pure Lili and then 2 other cards. And we do hit, I think we hit the copy of the spell here. We take 500 off that my friend as well, by the way. We have a Nib in the hand. We're going to be seeing a Sleepy, going to activate Descending, and then a copy of my friend. I'm going to be able to summon out a copy of Purrely. Purrely will then be able to search for a copy of the field spell, I believe, or the trap, depending on which option they want to be choosing. We do know that they have the Sleepy in the hand, therefore they could just go for the Baby Noir. Or they search for a copy of the Purrely as well here, hoping that when we normal summon it does not whiff. So we can then activate the effect of the Purrely, going to a copy of the E-Noir here, because we had the Sleep in the Graveyard. And then we can activate a Happy. We see nothing in chain, so we can activate the effect of the E-Noir to attach, to be able to set the trap from the deck. You know, that's a crazy effect if you ask me. We also chose to protect the copy of the My Friend. That's why we see that little counter on it. We're going to set one card here and pass. So interesting that we chose not to to send that copy of Purrely off that Happy to then be able to summon out another copy of Purrely to then look maybe at the top of the deck and draw one card. Interesting to me that we just didn't see that. But we're going to be going in the end phase. We're going to be activating the effect of the Arias. And that's going to let us set that copy of the Welcome Labrynth. Then we're going to activate the Welcome Labrynth here to summon out the copy of Ariana. Ariana will let us search for a copy of the Starby Torby here, and then we can select with the effect in the end phase if we wanted to, which we are going to be doing, discarding the copy of Nibiru, and then also chaining the copy of Lady here. Yeah, we definitely are not going to be needing that Nibiru here. We're going to be setting a copy of Big Welcome as well, and then during the draw phase, or standby phase here, we're going to be activating the effect of the Baby Noir here. We do chain the copy of Welcome, and there's no response to this. They will be able to chain Lady as well. And they're going to read the Welcome in the Graveyard. So even if they chain Yeep to this, we will be able to just... So we're going to target the Imperm, and then they're going to be chaining the effect of Arias to summon itself out. Then we're going to be summoning the copy of Lovely, and we could bounce, or we probably bounce the Lady back to the hand, or the Ariana, right? Then we're going to be seeing Lovely effects going to activate here, as well as the Ariana, and then the Starby Torby, as well as our copy of the Welcome, and we're choosing not to flip up Yeep to this. Then we're going to be summoning out the Lady from the hand and attack vision with that Ariana as well. Destroying the copy of Yeep. We could have destroyed the copy of Noir, but then they would be able to add back stuff. So we see Labrynth being in a really good position here. We can just go for a Chaos Angel as well if we wanted to, by just using the copy of Ariana and the Arias to go into that copy of Chaos Angel, banishing that copy of the Yeep here, and I believe we are still under 5 summons. We're going to be adding back those 2 cards. And let's see, we have the Lady Lovely. Ooh, this is summon number 5. Yeah, we're going to also have the Ariana here. So we got Lady Lovely, Ariana, and the Starby Torby, and Chaos Angel, right? We do have the Nib there. Very, very unfortunate for the Lab player here. They're going to think about this. Yeah, they're going to chain the Starby Torby sending itself. But Still very unfortunate. We could have had game throughout it because, you know, Chaos Rangers at 35, and then we attack. We have 60,000. We had enough for game there without even having to you know, play in the nib. But we do have the lovely Weekend Summon out here in the hand. Yeah, that's so unfortunate. We had game on board. We're going to see them normal summon a copy of the Purrely here. And do we hit that with a welcome? Okay. Will they chain so that we can't go? They are going to chain here with the pretty, making both players gain 1,000. And we also discard a copy of Imperm there to summon out from the deck. Summon out a copy of Pure Lili. And then we're going to be able to summon out from the deck, most likely going to be a copy of the Aria or Ariana here. And then we see, is that a double cross? But we do whiff off the Purrely there, which is very unfortunate. We're going to be seeing the Pure Lili as well as the Ariana activate its effects. Searching for a copy of My Friends and then a Ku Klok as well. We're going to see the Purrely going to activate its effects, targeting that copy of the Beauty. And it's going to let us go for the, well, I guess pretty, but it's going to go for the Beauty here. It's going to be a Veiler of some sorts. Kind of good against the Labrynth, or Lady Labrynth on the field here. We're going to then activate the effect to send, and we do chain, or we're going to attempt to suck up the Big Welcome. We're going to chain the Big Welcome to this. And then we're going to attempt to chain Lady as, or yeah, Lady as well. They're going to obviously Veiler it with the Beauty. But we're going to be summoning with a copy of the Lady, and then we're going to be able to... It's still going to suck it up because it stays on the field, I guess. But we get to bounce, then lovely little pop. And we see the Welcome and the Starbator. We summon itself out. And I feel like we just pop the Beauty, right? Yeah, so we're going to pop the Beauty here. And we will be able to add back those cards. So we're going to add back the Pretty. And that's unfortunately the only one that we can add back. So we're going to activate My Friend once again, revealing the copy of Sleepy, Pretty, and then another Pretty here. So maybe trying to go for another Beauty if they do play it, or they just... Yeah, like, why wouldn't they go for Delicious here? They already have a Delicious in the hand, but they already have a Beauty in the hand as well. Okay, so we're going to see Delicious and then a Happiness. They could go for the Happiness, not OTK, but like being able to search all your cards. And at that point, you just have the infinite advantage. And then you can go for a Noir and start spinning back cards. But I feel like at this point, Purrely is just like, well, we're lucky that we're even alive in this game. You know, we were going to get just instantly KO'd, but we decided to normal summon Ariana for some reason. We see the Sleepy can activate its effects, discarding the copy of Pretty here, bringing out most likely the copy of Pure Lili. Or another Purrely, okay. Purrely can then activate its effects once again, and do we whiff? We hit the sprint, the double cross once again, and we also saw, I believe, that was a Angler here, so maybe playing Purrely Sprite in this case, or the nice little level twos that we saw in other deck profile as well. We're going to be seeing the Purrely attach for the Happiness, and then start being able to go battle phase and start being able to do half attacks, and then being able to search for cards here. Searching for that copy of Delicious. And then we can, do we have another Happy in hand? We have Delicious that we can activate, chaining the copy of Happy. And that's going to attack into the copy of the Lady. And that's going to let us search for a copy of Sleepy here. Then we're going to activate another Happy, targeting the copy of Happiness. We're going to chain the Happiness, which can then reattack into the copy of Lady. Or lovely here, my bad. I keep saying lady, but it's lovely. You know, halving its attack and then, you know, making it so it can't be destroyed by battle is pretty nice. Doing the search once again here, searching for a copy of... But they, it does not matter because we attack with a nib, that's just going to be game. Okay, that makes sense. You know, being able to protect the lady and then just start attacking into it is very, very problematic. The happiness OTK is kind of crazy. I can't believe Purrely won that game. I really can't. A lot of our lab, like, lab is a complicated deck to play, which sounds so crazy to say because it, like, such a Pepega deck to play anyways. But, like, I don't know. To play lab correctly is kind of difficult, which is, it honestly is crazy. Like, it's a trap deck, but there are some, like, random lines where you want to be able to play and you have to, like, play it exactly, or you get like hard punished there. Like, we didn't see them getting hard punished, but that definitely was like a punishment type, like, sort of thing, by not having the best cards that we were, that we had game on board, and they had nothing they could stop us. You know, we weren't on the fifth summon because all we summoned was the copy of Lady, Lovely, and then the short Storby Torby, and then the copy of Chaos Angel. Like, that would have been summon number four, and this summoning the number five didn't get us anywhere as well. Like, it didn't advance our game state at all, which was kind of unfortunate for us because we did see, like, the Lovely Lady and then the Chaos Angel just would be enough for game. But we are going to be going sets and then activating the effect of the Starby Torby and pass turn on this, you know, moving on to that game two. But we see the effect here of my friend going to be activating, revealing the three happiness here. Then obviously we add the happiness. We're going to activate happiness, discarding the copy of Imperm. We definitely don't need that. Protecting the copy of my friend, summon up the copy of Pure Lilai. Pure Lilai would activate its effects, searching most likely for the field spell, or a copy of Purrely. We're going to see them go for the copy of Purrely. The field spell doesn't really help us out a lot in this matchup as well. So we're going to activate the effect of the Pure Lilai attaching, going for that copy of the happiness, and now we can start maybe seeing the OTK begun. I wonder what those face downs are. We might even see, I feel like Skill Gene would have been already flipped the face up. We're going to see a battle phase. They're going to declare an attack, and we do chain the Welcome Labrynth to this. We're going to summon out the copy of Ariana. Ariana's going to activate its effect, searching for the copy of Lady. So this Ariana does have a thick booty, maybe 21, and we can attack with the happiness. But now we can't really deal some damage, which is fortunate for us. So Labrynth kind of like not taking this game, but waiting for the last moment to kind of protect them. We see them search for the happiness here. And then we can attack once again with the happy, being able to search. We just take 100 life points, so it's not really like it's going to be doing much for us. We essentially just fill up our hand with cards. So we're going for another copy of happiness here, which we can then activate if we wanted to, chaining the copy of Lady to stop from it being used as XYZ material for that copy of happiness. That is a really nice strategy that, you know, you can abuse. It has to directly respond in chain. And so now we have to activate another copy of happiness to attempt to even try to. But we chain the big welcome to this as well here. And we do hit that with a bell, so we can't even chain Lady to it. In the same way that we can't chain our copy of the happiness here. We do go main phase two, normal summon a copy of the Purrely here. And now we're going to be activating the effect, seeing if we will whiff. We see a beaver sprite blue and then a trap, I believe. But we do have a link to our level 2, rank 2 on the field. So we'll be able to summon out a copy of the Jet. Jet can search us for that starter here. And so we are playing those sprite cards in this variant. Then we're going to be seeing the starter being able to summon, and we're most likely going to be summoning a copy of the blue here, or just a straight up copy of carrot as well could be an option. So we're going to go for the carrot. It's going to be a spell and trap negate. Most likely going to be trying to stop that spell and trap hate in the back row there. And then we're going to be going into a copy of Sprint. Sprint will most likely dump the Angler. Angler can summon back the two Beavers here. They're thinking about it. Okay. I feel like that's just the right option here, right? We're going to activate the effect of Sprint, send the Angler, summon out the two Beavers. And they're going to read the Angler. I do miss Sprite, but unfortunately, just Sprite's a little bit too fair. We're going to see a chain of Super Poly here, sending the Storby Torby to use both of them there for a Garua. That's pretty nice. Super Poly being a great a board breaker type card. And like now we just lost our spell and trap hate. And we can't even respond to the Super Poly, so it doesn't even matter. We could go for an SP using both the Beavers there, but it looks like we also have red in the hand as well. We have Welcome, Big Welcome, and then we have the Storby Torby in the graveyard as well. So they're looking in their extra deck to see what else they have. They do have a Gigantic they could go into, but Gigantic summoning a blue to go for a red doesn't really seem like that good of a board. So they're going to go into a copy of perhaps the IP. Yeah, going for the IP there, and then we can summon out the copy of red. We do probably set up the Cosmic, right? We're going to link away into an SP, and then SP's effects can activate. We probably just banish the Garua, honestly, so they don't get that draw, so they're on top deck. Because they just set one card here, and now they have to essentially draw into a trap that they can activate, which is just not a thing. So we kind of just deal with their board here. We can go Big Welcome Bounce. We're going to go Battle Phase Attack into the copy of Happiness with the Lady. Then my friend should add back. And we're thinking about chaining the Big Welcome to bounce back the my friend, but we just have Happinesses in the graveyard, so we can only add back the Happy. Unfortunately, not worth it. But we should have added the other cards. Like they thought they would get greedy and wouldn't get hit with that copy of the Ariana. But like we can crash the Ariana and the SP. But then we don't get anything else. We're going to activate the Big Welcome on the back row. And chain SP on the Ariana in itself. They're going to be able to set and summon out the copy of Chandelier. Or not Chandelier, but the... we're going to set the copy of set the copy of Welcome and then set the or summon out the copy of Storby Torby here. And we can make an SP of our own if we wanted to. We see a Yama face up in their hand here. So going for the Yama, and then we're going to be able to search for the copy of the Shawarma here. Shawarma can actually pop that back row, which is going to be a welcome. Which we do have popping that up. I think we also have the escape in the hand, which is very unfortunate. We can go for the rage, which, like, we can just set and then pass turn on this. We're going to see the Ariana and then the SP come back. And we turn to a trap here, which is super unfortunate. But they go happy. And we're going to send the trap here to summon out the copy of... I'm going to assume it has to be Purrely. Yeah, Purrely here. Then we're going to be chaining the Yeep to this to put back into the deck so we can actually add back that copy of Purrely. We then activate the effect of Purrely here. And targeting the happiness, we do chain the escape, targeting the rage alongside the Purrely here. They could chain SP, but rage can always chain to the SP there as well. And then we're going to be seeing the escape, or we're going to see the rage activates effects as well as the Yama. And then we also get to the set the copy of Welcome as well as the copy of Chandelier. And we can add back our copy of Lovely, our Lady here, yeah. And then we get the Ariana draw one. We could summon out with the Ariana to the Lady as well here. And we're big chilling. We're in normal summon with the Purrely, activate effects. And we do hit here. Hitting the copy of Pretty is absolutely huge in this grind game. We're going to see Purrely upgrade into a copy of Beauty. And so now we have another way to deal with the copy of Rage. With the Beauty there, you know, you can't really respond with SP. We probably should have tried to rage to go for it, but we're going to see my friend activate revealing my friend and then a sleepy. I don't know whether they'd reveal another copy of My Friend. We see them. Okay, I see. We see them hit the My Friend there, and that's going to be able to try to absorb the Rage. They're going to battle phase with the Beauty attack. Then we just make a big Zeus here, eh? Yeah. Zeus can activate its effects, sending everything to the graveyard. It is unfortunate, but like that's kind of the way it is. And we do have the Lady to summon herself out here as well in the hand. We set that Cosmic once again, and then we just draw for turn. So being on draw for turn once again, but facing a two-mat Zeus is kind of huge. We can't even beat over here. So like once again, we have to find a way to deal with a trap card without even they've doing it. We could have maybe gone for Typhon bounce, but it wouldn't really do anything for us. We're going to see them just pass turn on this, and now we have to play with two cards, but they have an Angler in the hand, so not the greatest. Typhon's kind of looking like one of our only options. We do see that they have two cards now in the hand, and they have a Bell, and I think, or no, they have a double cross here, which is very unfortunate. They kind of have to go for that copy of Typhon at this point. You know, they'll whatever they activate, they're going to get hit with that copy of Zeus. And like giving Purrely more cards just means that that we're going to get punished. But we're going to see them activate the effect of Pretty. They're going to get hit with an Ash Blossom there. And they set one card and they go try to Cosmic it, which was a copy of Big Welcome. That is huge. We see a Purrely going to be normal silent, activating the effects, and then a search for the copy of My Friend. The third copy here, absolutely crazy. Then we're going to activate the My Friend, being able to reveal the Sleepy Delicious, and then another copy of Sleepy. And no matter what we choose here, this is just going to be game, eh? I'm pretty sure the Purrely will be able to activate the effect attaching happiness to it. Still happy to go for the happiness. Now they're trying to maybe play around. Yeah, no, I think this is definitely the play. Then we go battle phase, attack. We take 1,000, but we get to activate the effect to to search here for delicious. And we also get the add back with the my friend. We only have two in the graveyard, so we could only have to add back those two. But our grind game now is essentially huge. We have lost a Yeep, but doesn't truly matter. We can go pretty, discarding the copy of Angler. We gain 1,000 life points each. And then we can summon out the copy of the Purrely here. Angler can activate unless... Oh yeah, we don't have any left in grave. Yeah, they're all in grave. So we're going to be whiffing off the Purrely. Then we're going to activate the effect going into a copy of Plump. Plump can then activate the effect to attach. And we're going to choose to attach the Welcome as well as the copy of the Pretty. And then the Pretty will let us also send cards to attach the Lady there. And then we also have Double Cross as well to be able to attach one of those cards that we see. Like if they try to summon out a body that's going to threaten us, we can now just go for that copy there. But we're going to be going into a Noir off the bat just by activating the effect activating the Sleepy Memory, chaining the copy here of the Plump, and then we can smack down a Noir on it. And at this point, we've just won the game. We see a Prod of Prosperity here. Pretty nice to be able to look through the deck. I feel like we should have gone for Typhon earlier if they're playing. They're playing Super Poly, so I'm going to be assuming they just don't have room for Typhon. But I do see an extra deck card that is black, so I'm going to be assuming that there was a Typhon all along. They could have slapped it down there, bounced that copy of Zeus. And we're going to be searching for the Ariana. Ariana will be a combo piece to let us play through that by being able to search for the copy of Kuklok. Now we can just activate the Kuklok effect here. And now when we activate a trap, we can just activate it. We're going to be activating the effect of Chandelier, setting the copy of Starby Torby to set that copy of Big Welcome. And then we're going to be able to activate the effect of the Kuklok to summon itself back out. So now Zeus has to be kind of careful, because we can always chain the Big Welcome here. But at this point, we're still so far ahead in the game. Noir being able to just shuffle back all those targets just definitely just is just incredible. We're going to go... activate Big Welcome, and they forgot to draw off the Noir here, but we're going to be seeing the Labrynth player just admit defeat, realizing that they've definitely lost the game. Yeah, there was no winning that. Like, they're against a Noir, so they just admit defeat here, realizing they just cannot win. And they do see whatever it's called in the deck, the virus there. But hopefully, as you're watching the video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to see more content like this. Stay safe. Peace.